Hi everyone, Ian here, and behind me is a brand new 2024 Bavaria Yachts R40. So let me show you some of the features and benefits that this particular yacht has to offer.
So this has to be one of the stylish 40-foot yachts out there on the market, in my opinion. It has two cabins, two heads. It has a phenomenal flybridge, amazing amenities, and some obviously really stylish design from its hull to the deck to the upper flybridge. The R40 is really packed with a lot of cool features. As we're working our way to the transom here, you're gonna see a large swim platform. This is actually a hydraulic swim platform. So here at the back of the boat, this will actually submerge, go fully underwater so you can float on and float off a dinghy. We have our shore power inlet here. We have storage. And then here at the back of the boat, this lifts up. And we have a really nice electric grill here at the back of the boat, along with a little cutting area and a sink. So great use of space back here. Again, that integrated with the hydraulic swim platform really packs a lot in here. We have the swim boarding ladder here, those two receptacles. There is a stainless steel grab handle mount that allows you to have easy access up into the boat as well too. Hot and cold swim step shower. We have our boarding entrance gate here. This is a stainless steel gate that'll close this area off. And then our manual controls for the swim platform flag holder. Large seating out here with built-in cup holders and drains as well. Really find that to be quite nice. Here in the aft cockpit, the table itself, you'll see adjustable legs on those. Those will actually drop down. There's our filler cushion here, turning this into a large lounge. And then when not in use, you can actually remove the table. Both this table and the table in the salon are fully removable, and you can get rid of them if so desired, or they have the additional opening leaves on both sides. This is a removable cushion, allowing us access to the starboard side of the vessel. And then we also have access on the port side. Here in the cockpit, we have a cockpit fridge, and then our steps boarding up to the flybridge. But before we go too far, I'm gonna take you off to the starboard side. We're just gonna come down here. We have a closure as well too. That'll enclose this aft cockpit, but built-in stainless steel grab handles. I mean, it's just great how they've really brought in all the elements of it, the design as well too, keeping it nice and clean. A large door access here right at the lower helm. I'm gonna show you some of the cool features that that gives you, and accessibility obviously up to the foredeck. When you're here up to the foredeck, you have a nice large wraparound windshield. We also have the horn, the spotlight. What I love about this is the backrests tilt up, and then this is a full canopy that'll come up and give you shade here over your head. So for those you know, long days in Catalina Island or just enjoying the bay, you really have a nice little area up here to kind of get away, and it really creates multiple zones throughout the yacht, which I really like. Cup holders on both sides. Again, large pad here, sunshade that's retractable. This is our anchor locker. It's set up with a Lumar Delta anchor. And then this opens up, and you can see just how far that goes down in there. And then we also have fender holders in there as well too. That's what those stainless steel plates are. Bench seat up here on the foredeck. And then again, just a really nice overview, really clean lines, you know, just how they brought into all of the design features. So it's not just all blocked out. They've really thought about it. Large window here that gives you access into the salon as well. And then again, just all these details. I really, really find it to be quite unique about just the time they spent on this R line, just giving you all of that that's there. All right, steps bringing us up right up into the flybridge. There is a plexiglass door that closes off, but here we are. The flybridge for a 40-foot vessel, Dometic fridge down below here. This opens up and closes off, so you don't have to go down below, but look at all of this seating. It is so impressive about really what it possesses. We also have the backrest that lifts up here up on a hinge, so you can have a lounging aft backrest as well too. We have two captain's chairs here that pivot in both directions. We have our Bennett trim tabs, our Volvo Penta throttle controls, our joystick control, our information for both engines there, adjustable wheel. And again, just they brought every little element in, you know, just making it to that next level, which I really love. Windlass chain counter, we have our horn, our bow thruster controllers, our Fusion stereo remote, and then our fob on and off for the Volvo engines as well. And two very large glass mat displays here, the Simrad. So really incredible feature. We have Fusion speakers here as well too. And they've actually brought in the Flex E-Teak up here on the fly. Tables themselves have a fold out leaves on both sides of that as well. Again, just so much room and space up here. I just really find this to be beneficial. We have the radar, we have the lighting, the VHF, the TV antennas. But again, when you sit back and you realize like this is a 40-foot flybridge, it is really impressive of what they've given you. A lot of them will just cut this in half and give you a lounge pad out here, but you have tons of seating here. We have our lounge access up there at the bow, large windshield as well too. And I can tell you, this is a really comfortable ride offshore. All right, as we come back down below, we do have an engine room access here. This opens up, gives us a quick access right down here. We have a Fisher Panda generator. We also have these are the Volvo D6 380 horsepower engines, engine fire suppression system. And as you can see, this is just a very, very clean engine room. But again, obviously we can go into more detail about that. And large refrigerator here with a small freezer compartment. And then now we're moving into this salon, and I want to show you what I've done here. So there are three glass doors. So you can have it set up so you have an easy access right through here, and then these two doors could slide over, or you can bring all of them, slide it behind here. Now you have this really nice, large, open access into the salon of the boat, which I absolutely love. As I mentioned, the table, these are fully removable. So if you did want to have this table removed and have this kind of an open lounge area, you can do that. You have lighting underneath the cabinetry, seating as well too, overhead lighting as well too. It's just absolutely really well done. Here we have an additional refrigerator with a freezer compartment. So this is much larger. So there are three refrigerators here. And then we move forward of that. We have a shelving. You're gonna notice these cutouts here, and that's for these, countertop covers. So we have the stovetop here. We have the sink under here. And again, large sink. But if you don't wanna use this countertop storage, you can actually tie those in and put those away. Also a dedicated area for a microwave storage trash bin. We have our Fusion stereo controller here, our two salon air conditioning heating controls, TV 12 volt and 110 USB outlets. That's all right here. This is where a TV would mount. So it'd be a nice setup. You also have overhead storage as well too. So again, they've brought in everything and not kind of limiting the window space that you see here. Mini blinds on all the windows as well. So that's quite nice if you want some privacy. And then again, the attention to detail, just, you know, really the stitching that they've done here and the quality is really impressive. I love the seats. These are like bucket seats. We have a passenger seat here, second passenger. And then we have the captain's chair there. We have step ups on both sides here. And then as we come up and into the lower helm, you can see just again how great that is to have this door. So if you were single-handing this boat, or you're like me, where there's other people on board, but you're single-handing the boat, this gives you easy access to run up, to get the mooring, to help, you know, anchor in any situation. Being able to have that access from here is quite nice. We have the Simrad VHF, again, engine controls, Bennett trim tab controls, joystick, throttle, displays, engine displays here, spotlight controller, and then this is the fire suppression controller, bow thruster controls, main VHF, and then your simple breakers here. What I got to show you is this. This is really impressive. So this walks us through, you know, our lighting. So we can go in, turn on, off any one of our lighting features here. navigation, water systems. We go into our water, you know, we want to turn on our fresh water, gray water, black water, gray water discharge. Tank status is all right here as well too. So this is a really easy setup situation here. We're going to go to our 115 volt you know, options, so we can kind of go through here. We can go through the next pages all the way to the air conditioning. Again, this is a very simple system that really took big panels and lots of breakers and really combined them right here into this situation. So I love that. Coming down below, we have three gradual steps. Now our landing is down to a carpet, so we are hardwood floors there. Our carpet, our first door that we come to, this is our dayhead access. So this is VIP cabin, or it could be a master cabin if you so choose, but this is the access here. We have Jabsco quiet flush electric toilets. They're freshwater flush, beautiful, really nice bowl sinks, nice high-end fixtures here with the faucets. Again, we have the mini blind option. This is all mirrored with lots of storage built in, 110 outlets with GFI breakers on that as well too, which is pretty rare in European boats. And then a nice full, you know, walk-in shower compartment. So shower compartment's quite nice. We have this little opening hatch. They've also, you know, did privacy screen on that window, but a great head. And I love the access here. So as you're coming down below the steps, you have great access into the dayhead, so you don't have to go into either cabin if so desired. Now here into the VIP or second master, as you some people would call it, you have these really nice great steps. You have access to both sides of the bed. We have hanging lockers on both sides as well too. Storage above all of this. A really nice you know, upholstered headboard with reading lamps. We have our own air conditioning heating controls. These are the filler cushions for exterior on those two tables that drop down and turn into additional lounges. So that's what that is for. And then the other cool feature I love is these will split. So let's say you have, you know, kids on board, or you know, they just want to have separate beds. Well, in a second, those will slide out. We'll also have additional storage under that. This will slide out and lock into place, but you can transform this bedroom, you know, to two twins or to a really center nice queen size berth. Again, hanging locker, just the really great use of space everywhere you turn. Really thick doors, so you find that quality, that German, you know, engineering throughout the yacht itself, and just the upholstery that they use on all of the bulkheads is quite nice. Now going straight aft, this is something, again, very, very rare in a 40-foot vessel, is this center line master cabin. Now, this is impressive. So obviously, you're coming up here. This is your headroom. This is your ceiling. Obviously, you're ducking down some, but you know, who doesn't when you're coming into bed or jumping in? So you have these step landings on both sides. I mean, the illusion of a floating bed, which is really nice. This large, you know, lounge, Cleopatra lounge system here. We have lighting on both sides, are really nice materials, you know, found on the headboard, the back wall itself, centerline queen berth. Look at all that storage across there, opening side hole ports as well too, hanging locker, and then the center area, you can mount a TV there if so desired, and then you also have a lot of extra drawer space, not to mention you have storage underneath this bench seat as well too, and really cool lighting throughout. So this is a master cabin, you know, definitely found in much larger vessels. I want to say you start getting up into that 46-foot vessel, that's when you're going to see a cabin like this. But they've done such a great job with the layout down below and what they've packed in there. Down below the steps, this lifts up, and we have access to some of our electrical components here. So it's a great use of space to be able to come down here and activate, you know, the breakers and some of the main electrical systems here without having to take up real estate here, where, you know, it's quite visual. Here we have our generator controls, battery switch controls, ship to shore breakers, again, bilge pumps. So that's a great easy access. And then all of our other main components are accessible from right here. All right, so I hope you found that video walkthrough to be helpful, informative. I can honestly tell you, I absolutely love the R40. I love its layout. Currently owning a 40-foot powerboat myself. There's a lot of features that I find in this yacht that I would definitely want to upgrade to. You know, large Flybridge that accommodates a lot of people, a hydraulic swim platform, being able to have a center line master, you know, at water level to look out the windows with that lounge area. So nice. Really, really impressive vessel. If you would like to experience this in person, please feel free to contact myself, Ian Van Tuyl, at any time, day or night. Thank you again. I look forward to hearing from you and hopefully earning your business, getting you, your family, and friends out on the water. All right. Bye for now.